Just imagine for a second that you're one of the head developers at Insomniac Games. The title you're working on, Spiderman for the PlayStation 4, is shaping up incredibly, and you cannot wait to show the world just how smoothly your version of Peter Parker can swing through New York City. You sit down in a planning meeting, and someone nearby begins to talk about how great it would be to throw in a few stealth sections, you know, to break up the gameplay a little. Not a bad idea, you think to yourself. Spider-Man creeping around, webbing up bad guys could be a great change of pace. The rest of the room also seems to agree, everyone nodding their heads almost in unison, before the person who suggested the idea suddenly adds, No, not for Spider-Man, I'm talking about stealth sections for Mary Jane Watson. You stand up from your chair, look them in the eyes, and request that they never ever make such a harebrained suggestion again. You sit back down in your chair, and after an awkward silence, the meeting continues. Mary Jane Watson's stealth missions are never mentioned again. Now, that's what should have happened when someone at Spider-Man developer Insomniac Games made that suggestion, but unfortunately they didn't, and instead you were forced to play through multiple Mary Jane Watson stealth sections during Spider-Man's campaign, and one or two featuring Miles Morales as well, and I just for the life of me cannot understand why. Spider-Man is in many ways an absolutely brilliant experience, and it's without doubt one of the best big budget superhero games since Batman's Arkham titles. It gets the mix of comedy, action and heart just right in its storytelling, has the best web swinging since Spider-Man 2 on the PlayStation 2, and does a great job of adapting the Arkham series combat mechanics for a completely different superhero. There are some issues here and there, the frankly ridiculous amount of collectibles littering the map being my biggest problem with the game, but apart from when I'm starting to get slightly bored collecting backpacks, searching for cats and chasing pigeons in order to secure upgrade tokens, I generally have a blast just swinging through the city as stylishly as I can. The web swinging is without doubt the highlight of the game, and is so fun that it makes Spider-Man's open world one of those rare occasions where an open world actually makes sense. If you have a movement mechanic so unbelievably strong that even someone who is as jaded as I am when it comes to open worlds is happy enough simply moving through it, then the only reason you should ever stop anyone being able to do that is if you have a very, very good reason as to why. And I'll tell you now, the Mary Jane Watson stealth missions are absolutely not a good reason. Not only are they incredibly linear and riddled with trial and error sections, but in terms of their mechanics, they are also extremely basic and introduce new ways to sneak around at a snail's pace. Snail's pace is actually a good description of the stealth missions as a whole, in all honesty. Take the first one in the art gallery. You've just been spending your time running up skyscrapers and swinging your way through the city, and now you get to stop and take some pictures. Not thrilling enough for you, you say? Well, there's no pleasing some people. How about a super simple sneaking section immediately after? And as if that wasn't enough, you even get to spend even more time solving pointlessly easy puzzles, something Spider-Man in general seems strangely obsessed with making you do all the time. But wait, it gets even worse. Insomniac then chooses to put you back in control of Spider-Man in the same art gallery, again doing stealth things, but this time actually playing as Spider-Man, which is much more engaging. It's bad enough the Mary Jane stealth sections exist at all, but what on earth were Insomniac thinking when they then decided to immediately contrast them with similar-ish sections using Spider-Man right after? It's almost as if they were trying to make it as obvious as possible that the Mary Jane sections just aren't really any fun. I mentioned that new ways to sneak are introduced as you move through Spider-Man's story, but they're still at their core incredibly basic. In the next Mary Jane sequence following the art gallery, you can knock over boxes to create a distraction, but only very specific boxes laid out in very specific places on your very specific path through the area. You later gain access to other gadgets which can be used to distract enemies and similar, but these sections never really move beyond being anything other than an irritating, boring distraction. Here's the kicker, when you look at them as a whole, you could never remove them from Spider-Man and build an entire separate game around them. And if they're not good enough to build an entire game around, then what's the point of including them at all? All they serve to do is dilute the actual Spider-Man experience, one which in general is pretty amazing. I know I go on and on about Titanfall 2, but look at the mission effect and cause in that game. It introduces a time-travelling mechanic which stands alone from everything else featured in the campaign, but it's one that works so well that you could conceivably easily continue building around it in its own separate title. If the Mary Jane sections were turned into their own separate stealth game, it would be boring, it would be uninspiring, and perhaps worst of all, it would damage the Spider-Man franchise as a whole. As they are in Spider-Man, there are some who might argue that they serve as a change of pace, but when that change of pace is a transition from roller coaster to glacial, it just doesn't work. Oh, and finally, in a similar vein to the issue I highlighted earlier in the art gallery where the game makes you play as Spider-Man immediately after a Mary Jane section, as if Insomniac are really trying to highlight how boring the minutes prior to retaking control of Spider-Man had been, how about this utterly bananas section in Grand Central Station? Here, Insomniac even manages to one-up themselves. Not only do they force you to go through yet another Mary Jane section, but this time, instead of reminding you of how rubbish they are after the section has concluded, you instead get to watch Spider-Man doing all the cool stuff while you bumble around. I find it absolutely mind-blowing, and not in a good way, much like the animations for Spider-Man on the ceiling, which are clearly missing, and his vanishing trick. How to summarise this video? Well, the Mary Jane sections are awful, and including such drab segments which take away focus from the things the game does so well is a very strange decision. They're in the game now, and there's nothing which can be done at this point, but if anyone from Insomniac is watching this video, which I guarantee they won't be, I implore you, stop it. Stop it and just let us play Spider-Man. Thanks for watching the video, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, do comment and let me know your thoughts, leave a like, hit subscribe and all that other good stuff as it really helps the channel, and hopefully I'll catch you all again soon.